After several days of tense, violent protests around the Seattle Police Department's East Precinct building, Mayor Jenny Durkin made the decision to pull out the barricades and officers defending the precinct. Shortly after, thousands of activists and community members took over and began occupying six blocks of Seattle's Capitol Hill neighborhood. The area first became known as CHAZ for Capitol Hill Autonomous Zone, but recently it's been called CHOP for Capitol Hill Occupied Protests.
CHOP is a tangible way for folks to demonstrate that our demands are not met and we will not leave until they are.
Some media coverages have presented CHOP to be more violent than it actually is, with President Donald Trump calling the space a product of an anarchist takeover.
When we see these reactions from the state in order to control communal activity, it's an indicator of something being done so effective that it's caught the attention of those in power.
Even though this is such a humanitarian issue that we're dealing with right now, people want to call it politics. They want to involve politics in it. And so I think that also is part of the reason why this is getting skewed, is because there's a political agenda that we're trying to push and saying that this is all violence, this is all politics, this is all these things, when it really isn't.
The six-block zone has been described to resemble more of a festival or a farmer's market than a protest. Speakers use microphones to discuss demands, artists paint murals, and many engage in conversations about race and discrimination. Those in the Capitol Hill occupied protests are looking for a systemic change.
The first demand is to defund the Seattle Police Department. The second demand is to reallocate that money into human services, so to reinvest money into efforts that will actually tangibly enrich Black communities here in Seattle. And the third demand is to free all protesters, and really emphasizing that there is no such thing as this bad or good protester dichotomy, that all protesters must be free. And all protesters are here for this common cause of advancing this movement for Black liberation.
Police have peacefully returned to the East Precinct building, but people from the Capitol Hill occupied protests continue to stay and plan to remain in place until real changes are made. Lelaine Ignau, ABS-CBN News.